Okay, what's up, Ampersand? Good late afternoon for me, Orc. It's extremely cloudy today, so it looks kind of like evening lighting-wise. Okay, he walks off. I gotta remember that. Oh, did you not, see me start this hack last time? So, the gimmick of... It's the entire level, yeah. The gimmick of the entire level is... It's kind of like 100 Rooms of Kuso. Except instead of... killing all the sprites on screen, you have to get a 1-up. And in this room, getting a 1-up involves bouncing on a bunch of enemies in the bubbles. Because every time you bop an enemy, your point counter increments. And at 16,000, you get a 1-up and you beat the room. You can do the fish too, but the fish are Kuso. They make you lose a bunch of altitude. I don't want to fuck with them. So you can pop the bubbles yourself, or you can wait for them to pop themselves. Both strats work. Fuck, I missed him. I was holding left, and I didn't get a high bounce. What's up, Joe? Play the first three worlds of Volpe's Friend. And my ROM hack race level, ROM hack races race level rather, if you haven't already. It's week 15, which is in season 2. It's up on SMW Central. This is fun. This is a fun level. Like, it's hard, but it's... fun. No. Hey, what's up, Brad? Oh my god, lucky turnaround. Fuck you, fish. Fuck out of here. The only thing better than not knowing if you turn around successfully is if you do it fucking off screen and you don't actually know until you lose a bunch of altitude. Oh my god. Oh my god, these saves. Come on, just a few more. Just a few more. Where am I? That was it! That was gonna be 16,000. Fuck me. One piece of advice I'll give to you is, so like, you know, most cape levels in Kaizo hacks, these days anyway, and two out of the six cape levels that have been made, namely mine and Carl's, have the turnaround patch, so, you know, when you press the other run button while you're flying, you will for sure turn around the other way. That makes turning around a lot easier. And as a result, what I see in people who have played those first without being exposed to like hard vanilla cape levels, like the ones that Pogyo makes, like Volpi's friend, Volpi Senpai, 100 Rooms of Kuso in this hack, which are, by the way, the other four cape hacks Pogyo has made, two-thirds of them. What I see those people do is they use turnaround as a crutch where they would be better off using just speed control, like speeding up and slowing down, and negative speed. And even in hacks that have spin patch, there are some sections which are made a lot easier if you just do fine-grained speed control instead of turning around all the time. Namely, I have made some sections in my hack in late game to sort of drill it into people that speed control is important to. Bad fish. Fuck. The people who play the vanilla cape hacks first don't really have this problem, since they intuitively try not to turn around, since handling a bad turnaround is difficult, or at least more difficult than controlling speed. You better flop the fuck away, fish. You better flop the fuck out of here. What am I at? Like 4K, 8K? Motherfucker, he went the other way when I wasn't expecting it. Yeah, what's up, Shevda? Thank you. This room is kind of fucked up. You can tell because it has, like, playground music. Fish. No. That's right, fall off the edge of the map. Well, I wasn't counting on that. Motherfucker. Can you? Jesus Christ. Fucking hate these fish. Right. Motherfucker. Fuck this bomb. I don't know how the fuck he's gonna move. Galoomba's new best friend. Yo, what's up, Tasty Beard? Thank you for the good luck. This is gonna take forever without the bombs. I think I have to, like, risk it. I forgot to hold left. This is extremely bad. Yo, what's up, MB? Thank you for the good luck. Oh, I'm dead. I'm doing alright, thank you. Hope you are as well. Maybe the key to winning this is to be, like, aggressive as fuck. Fuck. Except, not that aggressive. Okay, fuck the fish still, but, like, I think maybe I wanna go after the bombs more aggressively. That's a true story. I watched MB beat the first world of Volpi's Senpai in front of me at AGDQ 2020. And I don't think he's collected a cape ever since. Gotta go out on top. Okay. Okay. Oh my god. Extremely spooky series of events. It's after World 1, where Volpi's Senpai begins to get unreasonable pretty quickly. Like, the first level of World 2 was already like... felt like playing a Volpi's friend World 4 level for the first time. When did your first hack come out? Was it 2019? Got some tricky stuff in there that's a different variety than what Pogyo makes. It's basically like random setups that I would later put in my hack. Thank you for the good luck. This fish is on screen for a long time. Okay, he gone. Too low. I gotta wait for him to get out of his bubble. This one, on the other hand. Oh, I don't like this. I I think his directional change, like, saved me for once. You mean the 420 timer? Yeah, this is a Japanese hack, so you know, they're a little behind on the American memes over there. Fuck. What's the hot new meme these days? Like, they'll be doing that in 2030. Poggers, yes. Fuck. Actually, Pogo is already all about the poggers. I think X-Paco taught it to him. Corrupted his mind. He doesn't know cringe, though. So... 2030 for cringe for Pogo. And maybe he will have ceased to use poggers by then, so he'll have like half the meme. He'll be talking about cringe, but no poggers. Fucking fish. I don't know about that. I think there's a very real possibility of NASA, like, having a successful manned mission to Mars, and Pogo releases his, like, 10th hack without spin patch. Oh, this is bad. This is bad. Fuck. Fuck you, Umar. Are you saying I'm not your homie? Also, what's up, Umar? Yeah, what's up, New Pointless? Thank you for the luck. Oh! The midair! I don't like this fish. I'm not going for it. This fish needs to fuck off. This fish needs to fuck off. Good. That was big poggers. You must get a 1-up to advance to the next room. Like, I think I've about reached the maximum possible skill level for that turnaround tech. Like, if I'm paying attention, I can recover from a lot of bad ones. But it uses up, like, more space than the next level of tech. Which I don't have the patience to practice at the moment. Oh yeah, glitch. And here's a level built around that mechanic. I guess we're going under this guy. Motherfucker, turn around on me at the last second. This is not good. Hose? What you talking about, Shabda? Ain't no hose here, just Galoombas, bombs, and motherfuckers. Oh, I got you. Finally, that fish fucked off. Jesus Christ. No. No, 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 no. Fuck. This is indeed a Pogo hack. You can tell by the way that it is. What's up, plot? Two more. Can we fucking do it? Can we fucking do two more? Good. Fuck off. One more. One more. The fish resets it to 200. The fish fucking resets it to 200. Yo, what the fuck? I thought those motherfuckers counted. That's some bullshit. What's up, Philip? That is some bullshit. Alright. Well, now I fucking absolutely have to avoid them. Thank you for the clip. Nobody clips my shit anymore. I used to have a bunch of good clips. Well, I still do, but they're all old because no one clips my shit like recently. Okay, that was a rough one. How does this work again? Oh, right. Bounce. Umar, remind me what the last one is, because I know it's something that, like, half the people don't know how to make work. And I don't know whether I'm going to remember it. Probably just get the first one real quick there without killing the man. Yeah, something like that. Is that a fucking four bucket? Oh, it's got the turnaround assist blocks. That's good, I guess. Don't like that. That's one. Drop cape. I assume that means get out of flight state. Bounce off the last one, and then run into the shell without picking it up. I'm probably gonna go get a video of it. It parses, but I can't visualize what that means. Fuck. wish they weren't anymore. Oh wait, right, they have the Koopa Man in them. Okay, I think I know what you mean now. You can get two for one for the bounce, and then one for killing the Koopa Man in it. I remember now. It's coming back to me. Thank you, Umar. If you get a slow enough speed, it looks like you stick to those. If you're like going away from them, there's something weird about them. I think they've killed me at least once now. Hyper 6 World 6 Koopas. You mean the torsos? It's not a patch so much as map 16 edits. Anyway, what Pogia told me on Twitter is that he doesn't really care as long as it doesn't change the level design. Gaming. Get out of here. Fuck. That four bucket down there is fucked up. Okay. Thank you. Oh yeah, also Umar, if you're still here, I take issue with your assessment of this hack's any percent being easier than Volpe's friend. Because it don't feel that way to me. I think you're incapable of telling the difference between easy cape shit anymore. Seems like I want to be aiming for the center. And slow falling. That seems maybe consistent. So far, so good. Thank you for the good luck. Good. Can we not, though? This guy is a scumbag man. Scumbag man, if you will. Second cousin of footballman. Charles Chuckington Footballman III. As we decided he would be in Amethyst chat the other day. Fuck. I think I squandered a PB there. It's like the only time I've ever wanted zero speed in the cave hack. Those recovery blocks are quite possibly making it worse for me. Okay, I guess we can just do that. Gotta get used to them. Really? Fuck. I panicked trying to get out of there quickly. Yeah, these definitely fuck with your speed. After you get the turnaround. Unfortunate. Thank you. Okay. Now I'm missing the center, that's great. I don't think I should try that. Miss Macbeth, thank you. I think this is about time for PB. Let's go for that one, I guess. This is definitely a PB now. Okay. What do I do? What do I do here? Let's reread Umar's commentary. Drop cape. Bounce off the last one. Oh god, that means I have to bounce on it while it's bouncing down there. I guess if I aim for the middle, that's still as hard as if I'm slow floating. I think it's the same speed. I think it's the same speed. Fuck. All right. I hit select accidentally instead of start. Good. I am gonna patch that out next play session. Not doing that again. Magic time. Not doing that again. Fuck you. Nope, not doing that again. Right. Where was I? Come on. Alright. Fuck. This is a lot easier if you learn to work with the turnaround assist blocks, but like, goddamn, they are unnatural. Jesus Christ. Get out of here. Oh my god. Big poggers. I don't want it. I don't want to touch this fucking thing. I hate it. These are no good. They pull you in if you have, like, sufficiently low speed in the other direction after the turnaround. They're not good. They're not good blocks. Huge poggers playing. What is this hack? Well, the name's in the stream title, if you're curious about information aside from the name of the hack, feel free to ask. What's up, Spud? Thank you for the good luck. This escalated quite quickly. Difficulty wise. That's not helpful. I'd say the difficulty is in between Volpi's friend and 100 Kusos, Spud. Look forward to it. Love to see it happen. Super is a very ROM hack. As with many fucked up hacks, I very much enjoyed Link Dead's blind playthrough of it. And Bolops was pretty entertaining too. Great. Okay. If that's not how you win, then how do you win? I guess you have to bounce off the dude, but... What's up, Bola? Bolop, what did I do wrong? I'm pretty sure you got this far. I've seen it before, but I forget it, and I don't want to figure it out. Hit shell, not Koopa. Okay. I guess stunned enemies don't count, like, in general, because I think that that gave me 200, which means it reset the score, the bounce score, and a flopping fish also reset the bounce score, as I found out in the previous room the hard way. Alright, let's do it again. Don't hold Y also so you don't grab it. Yeah, good call. Good. Yes, but the gimmick is to progress to the next room, you must get a 1-up. Okay, we take those. Thank you. Holy shit. And the helper blocks kill me. Imagine missing a cake pump in 2020. Oh, that would have been something. Not really liking this room. It reminds me of 100 Rooms of Kuso in a bad way. Kuso is 100 rooms of... You have to destroy all the sprites on the screen to advance to the next room, and each room is a checkpoint. If each room weren't a checkpoint, then it would be impossible for humans. But some of the rooms are sufficiently fucked up that even with each room being a checkpoint, the hack is extremely difficult. Checkpoints would be possible for humans to clear. One. Umar, did you hear me say that? I'm pretty sure this is more difficult than Volpi's friend. Like, either that or I've gotten worse at Vanilla Cape since, but, like, I'm 99% sure that's not the case. No. Don't fucking die. Gotta use the fucking block now. Fuck me, right? You know what? I'm glad I didn't make that. Fuck. I forgot you can dodge it by being too low or too high. Like, this feels like very late game 100 Kusos territory for me. And that is a hack I played very recently. Get the fuck out of there. Wait, does that count? Does that count, or does it have to be like bouncing around on the floor? I guess I'll find out after I hit this one. The first one was 200, then that was 400. Okay, so it looks like it counts. That's good. Get out of here. I fucking hate that so much. You probably didn't need to use those blocks in your playthrough, Umar, but they're janky. If you have like a slow speed, like one speed, when you turn around off of them, it like zeroes it out. You like stick to them. And then you fall and die. Yeah, that's fine. I'm just providing another data point. IMO, this is in between 100 Kusos and Volpi's friend, so far. If I spend 6 hours on a room, then this will be harder than 100 Kusos. Yeah, sure seems like it. Please don't miss cake pops. This room combines like multiple unsavory aspects from rooms in 100 Kusos. Like, you have to contend with the Koopa cycle, and that's from room 98. You have to bounce on the shell, that's from room, I forget what. Where it's like the three shells bouncing. Like, whether or not I hit this does not seem to be entirely within my control. Like, if I aim for the center, I usually get it, but not always. Thank you. Okay. I need to turn around. Some good speed, and I shall take it. I think if I stay up here, it won't hit me. Like, if I do that. I'm a fucking idiot. A Koopa's gonna come out of it eventually, but it's gonna walk off into the lava and not be useful to me. Don't do that next time. Fuck you, game. What's up, Tater? Time for this thing to fuck me. I cooperated for once. That's nice. Good. Holy shit. Almost. See? It fucked me again. Fuck those blocks. All my homies hate those blocks. What's up, TM? There are, and it is sad. You're right. Oh, what the fuck have I done? I felt like it disappeared before I hit it, or maybe sprites disappear when I die. Let's test that hypothesis. No. Why did it disappear? Whatever. Just don't do that again. Subxander, goody. Pretty sure I would have died had I not gotten that turnaround. That was like a last ditch effort to not die. Never mind. My capture does this sometimes. It gets choppy. I don't fucking know why. It's not the PC. It's not OBS. I've got spare CPU time. Is it this fucking piece of shit Elgato? Let's have a look. Is it time for a new capture card? smooth now. So resetting the video feed seems to fix it. I think it's gonna be time for a new video card. Capture card, rather. Good. If it gets shitty again, someone in chat, like, let me know so I can reset it until my replacement capture card arrives. GV gang. So I need to capture, ...720p over HDMI. Does it do that? So if it can do that, I'll try it out. Oh yeah, no, I'm playing on an HDMI out system, so... Actually, let me see something. Whoops. Yeah, I know that a Super Nintendo can be made to look approximately this good, but this is, it's not a Super Nintendo. So, gotta be capturing that HDMI. Shenzhen's special USB 3 box. Okay. Yeah, I've got USB 3. I would prefer not to have a USB 1, because, fucking hate those blocks. Because I have a USB 1 that I use to, stream at, like, GDQs and stuff. And it has a quarter second latency. Which is not ideal, because my reactions to things in the game don't quite line up with the game.
Okay.
guess I'll see what the world of PCIe Capture Heart cards has come up with since I bought this one. It's been like 4 years. I was not expecting to live there. Out of here. Fuck. I'll take a look at that one later. It's not gonna work. Have a good look. Alright. Just don't kill the man. Just don't kill the man. You're hitting this block here. Don't kill yourself either. I fucking hate those blocks. Holy shit. I hate them so much. Thank you. Those are so bad. I feel like they're different than the ones in Volpi's Friend, because the ones in Volpi's Friend, like, didn't fuck me up from what I remember. Unfortunate. Good speed. It's okay. Okay, another good speed. Cycle after this, we're gonna get this out of here. Okay. Don't press select. So press select. Is there a video of someone beating this? I really don't want to fuck this up again. Is this gonna be another fucking case of there is no video of this because it's not considered sufficiently difficult? Just like there was no video on the internet of anybody like playing any Volpe's Friend levels before World 4. Umar, Bolop, are either of you still here? I don't think there's any video of this. Well, that's good. A video of the version of this in special. Alright, here, let me run it by you. Because we're both engineers, I'm gonna try to be clear and concise. The shell is bouncing down there. I'm gonna lose flight. I'm gonna bop the shell. And then we're gonna have a stationary shell and a coupling. And then I'm supposed to just, without holding Y or X, very important, so that I do not grab it, I just bop the shell without a Koopa in it. And that's it. Is that correct? Oh, got video. My god, this looks awful. Yeah, okay. That is what I said. Thank you. We will attempt that. Oh, and it's over. Thank fuck. Thank you, Bolan. That was a rough one. That was a rough one. That was like an hour plus. Sup, Golden Rules. Sup, Skeleton Pump. Thank you. Okay. Oh, I remember this. This is Pogyo's, good. Pogyo's very bad experience playing Zelda 2, was it? Where everything is just hidden in random fucking places. Oh, let's see if I remember where things are here. So we want a nice, slow speed so we can just hit all of these. You don't want to hit the edge, because that'll zero out your speed. Well. Which ones did I miss? I think I missed this one. Yeah. You what? Fourth from the right. Gee, I hope it's not randomized. I forget whether it's randomized. It sure would be a fucked up thing to do to randomize this. Alright, it's not. Still have to catch it though. Up throw. Up throw looks like it'll work. Unless there's some invisible shit above me that I don't see. Hey game, I'd like to go the other way. Thank you. It's gonna fall out to the left if I hit it this way, right? Yeah, okay, good. Is Zelda 2 actually this fucked up? What are we gonna do here? You have to kill them all? Is this actual 100 Kusos? That's not good. That's not good. Yeah, I don't see there being any other way to win. Other than to just kill all these dudes. False walls in the final dungeon. That's horrific. Oh my god. Well, can't win anymore. That's not great. Okay. What's up, TJB? Thank you. The room before this, the last room of the, shit. Of the 1-up level, took me for a ride. Okay. That's not good. Okay, so it is just more 100 Kusos. Okie doke. Hidden switch. Oh, there it is. We found it. Like 100 Kusos, room 80. Easy version. See how many hits I can get here. Nice. Hooray for no cooldown. This is a good speed. Okay, right back where we were. There's another one. Okay. That is good to know. Lots of them. Okay. This is where you learn to backwards fly. Mm. It was 100 kusos for me. What's going on here? Okay, so whatever I want is probably hidden in one of these. So there's a Cooper in there. I must admit I'm not exactly sure what's going on here. Do I make him kick the shell over here? Where is it again? It's like 8 from the left. Something tells me this is not what I want. He's not getting any farther from the left wall. So this will just continue happening. Good. This is just... I don't know. I don't know what I'm doing in this room. Not quite sure. Alright, so I wanna... open this thing when he's to the left of it, presumably. There's something in there, isn't there? P-switch? Maybe this isn't a 100 kusos kill all sprites room, maybe there's just... there's a P-switch in there and I gotta catch it and press it. And there's a P-door or something, room. Okay. Let's make that our working assumption. Yep. Fuck. I'm enjoying it a bit better again after the last room of the previous level. Like, I'm beginning to have fun again. It was pretty rough for a while with that room, though. Where's the Koopa? Did he despawn? He despawned. Will reset. Shit. This feels a touch luck-based. It fucking... There it is. That's where the P-door is gonna be. It all makes sense now. It all adds up. Okay, fine. So I don't even need to hit this mid-flight. I just need to get in there with it. Actually, I can't hit it mid-flight, unless mid-flight was very close to here, because I wouldn't be able to get into the door. Yeah. Okay. What do we got here? Oh. Hidden blocks. No shit. Okay, this has the potential to be trash. Do I have to come up with cues and shit? Alright, doing it immediately doesn't seem to work. You need to wait for him to spawn in at a minimum. And then, I don't know what else. This looks like it might be good. No. It's too late. Alright, I think you want the Koopa to hit it when the Boo is like near the bottom, right? Like this might work. No, not even. Earlier. Well, this is gonna suck to learn, and then execution is an entirely different story. He's got the Kuso blocks here. Maybe I'll just get lucky. This is gonna hit, maybe. Nope. Well, this will. Okay. Can I get a good spin? On second thought, yeah, I don't feel like playing this. This hack has sort of gone downhill in enjoyability for me in the past two levels. I think I'm gonna enjoy myself with a run instead. Alright. Thanks for hanging out, folks.